In this video, we will look at a type of animal tissue. There are four major types of animal tissues: epithelial, connective, muscular, and nervous. The focus of this video will be connective tissue and its types. Connective tissue is the most abundant animal tissue, and its purpose is to provide a structural framework for the body. It originates from embryonic mesoderm, the layer between the endoderm and the ectoderm. All types have three components, which are cells, matrix, and fibers. We will start by understanding the different cells present and their functions. There are five different types of cells, and these are fibroblast cells, plasma cells, macrophages, mast cells, and adipocytes. The function of fibroblast cells is to form the fibers that make up connective tissues and also secrete the matrix of the connective tissue. They are irregular in shape and large in size. The next type of cell is the macrophage. Macrophages are a type of phagocytes that play a crucial role in the immune system. They perform phagocytosis to destroy pathogens in the body such as viruses and bacteria, and also destroy damaged or dead cells in the body. When they are present in a tissue, they are called macrophages, and when they are in blood, they are called monocytes. Then we have mast cells. It is also known as basophil when in blood. It is amoeboid in shape, which means its shape is not fixed and can change to aid in movement. Their function is to secrete hormones. The three main hormones they secrete are histamine, serotonin, and heparin. Histamine is released during infections and allergic reactions and also acts as a vasodilator and a bronchoconstrictor. Serotonin is the opposite of histamine, as it is a vasoconstrictor. And lastly, heparin is the anticoagulant. Next up, we have plasma cells. Plasma cells, also known as plasma B cells, are a type of B lymphocytes that play a crucial role in the immune system. They have a cartwheel-like nucleus and will be seen in large numbers during infections, as their role is to secrete antibodies. We will now move on to the second component of connective tissue, the matrix. Matrix plays a major role in providing structural support to the connective tissue. It helps keep the cells together, helps the cell communicate, and helps in developing and repairing the tissue, and acts as a selective barrier to the external environment. Lastly, we have the third component of fibers. Fibers can be divided into three types: white collagen fibers, yellow elastic fiber, and reticulate fibers. White collagen fibers provide strength, so they are present in areas of body where strength is required, such as tendons. They are heavy and rough. They are made of the protein collagen. They are unbranched and straight and are found in bundles. Yellow elastic fibers are present where there is movement because, as the name suggests, it is elastic. The protein present in it is called elastin. The fiber is branched and is found singularly. Reticulate fibers are delicate fibers present where there is a need for movement. It is made of the protein reticulin. It is mainly present in lymphoid organs, spleen, or lymph nodes. And lastly, it is unbranched and found singularly. Now that we know the basic components of connective tissues, we can look at the various types. The first level of classifications divides connective tissue into the proper connective tissue and specialized connective tissue. Under proper connective tissue, we have two types: loose connective tissue and dense connective tissue. Loose connective tissue further divides into areolar and adipose connective tissue. On the other hand, dense connective tissue divides into dense regular and dense irregular. Going back to the first level of classifications, we have two types of specialized connective tissue, which are skeletal connective tissue and fluid connective tissue. Skeletal connective tissue has bone and cartilage, whereas fluid connective tissue has blood and lymph. I will quickly give a brief of each type of connective tissue in this chart before we dive deeper into each one. Proper connective tissue, also known as ordinary connective tissue, is the most abundant type in the body. Specialized connective tissue includes types that are uniquely structured and functionally specific to certain systems of the body. Under proper connective tissue, the difference between loose and dense connective tissue is that loose connective tissue has more matrix and fewer fibers, whereas dense connective tissue has less matrix and more fibers. To remember this, we can consider matrix as the water in noodles and fibers as the noodles. When there are more noodles than water, it is dense, and when there is more water than noodles, it is loose. Under loose connective tissue, we have two types, areolar and adipose connective tissue. Areolar acts as the support framework for epithelium, whereas adipose tissues act as the storage site for fats in the body. Under dense connective tissue, we have dense regular and dense irregular. As implied by their names, dense regular tissue has uniform density, while dense irregular has varying density. This difference comes from the arrangement of fibers, as fibers in dense regular are placed in a regular pattern, and fibers in dense irregular are placed in an irregular arrangement. Under dense regular, we have two types, tendons and ligaments. Tendons are present between a muscle and a bone, whereas ligaments are present between two bones. Going back to specialized connective tissue, we can see it is divided into two types, skeletal and fluid. Skeletal connective tissues provide structural framework to the body and construct the body skeleton, whereas fluid connective tissues help in the transportation of substances around the body. Skeletal connective tissue has bones and cartilages, whereas fluid connective tissue has blood and lymph. Bones and cartilages are solid and rigid, while blood and lymph, as suggested by their names, are fluid and capable of flowing. This is it for this video, and in the next one we will discuss each type of tissue in more detail. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe to our channel.